In this video, we're going to consider the difference between electric potential and potential difference and how they're connected. You might already be familiar with the idea of potential energy, specifically gravitational potential energy. Objects fall from a place of high gravitational potential energy to a place of low gravitational potential energy. Here, we will learn about a different but comparable form of potential, electric potential. Electric potential energy is the work needed to move a unit of electric charge from one point to another in an electric field. We can look at an example to get our heads around what this really means. Say there's a positive charge, Q, at some fixed point in space. P is a point r meters away from the charge, Q. Imagine that a positive test charge is placed at point P. Due to the presence of charge Q in its vicinity, the test charge will experience a repulsive force. Therefore, it has electric potential due to charge Q. We can measure the electric potential, V, at any point, as long as we know the distance of the test charge from the charge R and the value of the charge Q in coulombs. V equals the product of K and Q over R. Here, K is fixed. It represents Coulomb's constant, which is around 9 times 10 to the 9th newton meter squared per coulomb squared. So that's the definition and formula for electric potential. The second term we'll introduce in this video is potential difference. Potential difference is simply the difference in electric potential, V, between two points, and it's more commonly known as voltage. Consider two points, A and B, at distances R1 and R2, respectively, from a point with charge Q. To calculate the potential difference between A and B, we first need to calculate the electric potential at each point, then find the difference. The potential difference equals VB minus VA, which is equivalent to K times Q over R2 minus K times Q over R1. Rewriting the equation, we get this. Both electric potential and potential difference are scalar quantities measured in volts. A household battery's potential difference may typically be around 1.5 volts, while for lightning, this can be as high as 150 million volts. A potential difference between two points causes movement from one point to another. It's just like a waterfall, where water flows from a higher gravitational potential to a lower one. Similarly, potential difference, or voltage, moves charges around a circuit, resulting in an electric current. In a DC battery, one terminal has a high potential and the other has a low potential. The current flows from the point of higher electric potential to the point of lower electric potential. However, this is only true if the charge being moved is positive. A positive charge moves from a high potential to a low potential. But if the charge is negative, the reverse is true. The negative charge moves from a low electric potential to a high electric potential. Just because one side of a battery has a minus sign and the other has a plus sign, don't assume that one has a negative electric potential and the other has a positive one. The side with the minus sign actually has an electric potential of 0 volts. In contrast, the side with the plus sign has a higher electric potential. Therefore, the value at the plus terminal equals the potential difference between the two terminals. For example, a battery being 1.5 volts means the plus terminal is 1.5 volts higher than the minus terminal. Let's try using our new equations in two examples. Question 1. A point charge has a value of 2 nanocoulombs. What's the electric potential at a second point 0.5 meters away? Let's take our equation for electric potential. V equals K times Q over R. K is always the same, Coulomb's constant. In this case, Q is 2 nanocoulombs, and R is 0.5 meters. Inputting the values we know and solving gives us an electric potential of 36 volts. Question 2. A point charge has a value of 1 nanocoulomb. What's the potential difference between two points, one 0.5 meters from the point charge and another 0.25 meters away? We'll need this formula from earlier to calculate the potential difference between the two points. Inserting our known values and solving for potential difference tells us that the answer is 18 volts. so the potential difference between the two points is 18 volts. That's it for today. You can pull out these equations to solve new problems regarding electric potential and potential difference. To solidify your understanding, it's a good idea to try out some practice questions. Thanks for watching.